Spirit of the true God, Spirit of the only God, we come right now in the blessed name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
We praise you, Lord. Because praise is what we do.
Amen.
And Heavenly Father, whatever our condition is, we praise you, Lord. Now, God, our Father, we just ask that you think with my mind, speak through my mouth, stand in my body, and let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight. O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So sure, that was my phone going off. I don't even know where it is. That's a good thing. Praise God. It'll be all right.
Yes, God.
Sacrifice. Sacrifice. All of us have made sacrifice. Sacrifice may be defined as giving up something to aid you in achieving another goal.
Amen.
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 I have a desire to lose some weight. So there's a sacrifice that I'm going to have to make. I'm going to have to give up some of those sweets.
Mm-hmm.
And I love them pies and cakes. Amen?
Amen.
But they just keep the pounds on.
Yes, sir.
So I'm going to have to sacrifice. All of us have parents have made sacrifices for our children.
Amen.
In order that they can achieve the goals that they wanted to achieve and we wanted to see them achieve. We had to make what?
Sacrifice.
Sacrifice can be also defined as the killing or slaughtering of an animal, a bird, a reptile, a fish, or even a person for divine purposes.
Amen.
Rendered unto a deity,
such
as God or God.
Mm-hmm.
Images that people form and call them God. Kings and queens that people worship. Sacrifices are made unto them for cleansing and the atonement of sin. In the Judeo-Christian tradition, sacrifices were made for the atonement of sin. I'm quite sure all of you are familiar with the story when God told Abraham to bring his son and to sacrifice his only son. And when they got to the place of the sacrifice, Isaac asked the question, where is the lamb? And Abraham replied to him that God
will provide Amen.
Himself. Abraham looked and there was a what? A ram in the bush that God provided, and they sacrificed that ram, but because of man's continuous disobedience to God, God had to do something about that.
Mm-hmm.
And so he decided, not Abraham's son, but he gave what?
His only
begotten son.
Amen.
That whosoever what? Believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. So Jesus the Christ became that what? Sacrificial lamb. Amen?
Amen.
And after the sacrifice of Jesus, there was no need for any more blood sacrifices. For the place in which the sacrifices was done, they tell me the veil of the curtain was torn.
Amen. Yes, sir.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
From bottom to top, meaning that was not necessary anymore.
Amen.
Wasn't necessary to sacrifice anything for the atonement of man's sins, because even though they sacrificed the lambs and they sacrificed the goats and the pigeons, man continuously disobeyed God. So God provided another means. He allowed his son to be sacrificed, and those who believed in him, he gave them another power. The presence of what? The Holy Spirit.
Amen.
That exists within us.
Amen.
And so this morning, my brothers and sisters, Almighty God has led me to a passage of scripture as we talk about worship and sacrifices being the center of worship. Amen?
Amen.
Here in this 12th chapter of Romans, we find these words. I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye present your bodies a living sacrifice. Come on, say living.
Living sacrifice.
Holy, acceptable to God, which is your reasonable service. Now here in the King James it says reasonable service, but in the ISV it says reasonable worship. Amen?
Amen.
So that word service can be translated into what? Worship. Your reasonable worship. And do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove that what is good and acceptable and perfect will of God. I want to talk to y'all just for a few minutes about being a living sacrifice. Amen?
Amen.
A living sacrifice. Message this morning comes to us from the book of Romans. Romans being a letter found in the New Testament. This letter was written by the Apostle Paul. Paul writes this letter to a city that he had never even visited before. Writes it around AD 57 while he is in Corinth. And most of the letters, the epistles that you find in the New Testament that Paul writes, he writes it to that congregation, and he's addressing the problem that existed in the congregation after he left.
Amen.
Or something that they need to do. But he's speaking specifically to these people because he knew them. Mm-hmm. He started the church there, and he's giving them a little additional advice. But Rome, Paul had never been to Rome.
Mm-hmm.
Never been to Rome. He never preached in Rome. He didn't have a church in Rome. So this letter that's addressed to Rome is a doctrinal letter. He's explaining what Christianity is, because the church had already been established in Rome.
Yes, sir.
And guess what? Some of them was wrong. Amen.
Yes, sir.
They wasn't getting it right. And Paul wanted to make sure that they got the message right.
Amen.
And in this letter, There's two things that are explicitly emphasized. One is that salvation comes through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior.
Amen.
And the second thing that he emphasizes in this letter is that with salvation, we have the power of the Holy Spirit within us. Amen?
Amen.
You remember when we was at Green Valley, I made the statement that if ye children of God are those who are what? Led by the what? Spirit of God. And because we've accepted Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior, God's Spirit, amen,
amen,
abides in us. I love this letter, for there in the first chapter there's a familiar verse that says, I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ Jesus, because it is the what? The power unto salvation.
Amen.
I ain't ashamed about being a Christian. Tasha, are you ashamed? I'm not ashamed.
No, sir.
Of being a what? A child of God.
Amen.
And then he makes it clear in chapter 3, because he says what? All have what? Sinned and come short of the glory of God. Oh, yes.
Yes,
he's
sir.
Talking about me.
Yes, sir.
Then there in chapter 5, he says, but God demonstrates his love toward us. What? In that while we were yet sinners, Christ what? Died for us.
Amen.
I don't know about you, but that
Amen.
Makes me feel pretty good.
Yes, sir.
When I get Amen. Over to chapter 7, I start reading, and there's a passage of scripture there. Brother Tim says that when I will to do right,
Amen.
Evil prevails me. Oh, wretched man am I.
Yes, sir.
Who can deliver me?
Yes.
And then he makes it clear there's only one that can deliver me, and that is who? Jesus Christ.
Come on, Pastor.
In chapter 8,
yes, sir.
Allows us to know the power of Christ in us.
Yes, sir.
He lets us know that. He tells us, and I love this, I think it's around verse 28, he says all things work together for what?
The good
of them who love the Lord and are called according to his purpose.
Amen.
That's me. So don't worry about that situation. It's going to turn out how? For the good. And then he ends that chapter with some profound words where he says, I'll let nothing separate me
from
the love of God.
Amen.
And I admonish each and every one of you this morning, don't let
nothing
separate you
yes, sir.
From God's love.
Hallelujah.
In chapter 10, he just tells us exactly what all of us must do. He says, if you what? Confess with your mouth.
Amen.
And believe where?
Amen.
In your heart. He says, thou shalt what?
Be saved.
And thank God that we have that salvation through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. And how do we know about it? He says, who tells them? The preacher. And how shall they preach unless they be called and lest they be sent? I'm glad I just didn't went.
Amen. Amen.
I'm glad I was sent. Amen.
Yes, sir.
Called them sent to deliver the gospel. But here in chapter 12, he makes it explicitly clear what it is that God wants us to do. You see, all of us are saved once we believe that Jesus is the Christ.
Amen.
That's salvation. But just because we've received salvation doesn't mean that we've made Jesus our Lord. Oh, you didn't hear me.
Yes, sir.
See, because the Lord, you what? Obey.
Amen.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
Just being saved, we're saved because of our belief in our faith. But when we make Jesus our Lord, mm-hmm.
Amen.
Good God from glory.
Amen.
Some good things happen to us.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Some good things happen to us. When we follow Jesus, we're going to be what? Blessed.
Yes, sir.
We're going to be blessed. I wouldn't be getting up in front of you telling you about Jesus if I hadn't witnessed the blessings that he's given me. Amen.
Amen.
It's a poor preacher that stands in front of folk and talk about his problems and what God won't do for him.
Amen.
God is doing it for me. Amen.
Amen.
Is he doing it for you, Brother Tim?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes.
As long as I follow him, he keeps on what? Blessing me.
Glory
anybody
to God.
Here experience those blessings?
Glory
just
to God.
Keep on Amen. Following him.
Yes,
and
sir.
He keeps on blessing you.
Amen.
We're not going to be long this morning because it's a short passage. He said, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye present your bodies a living sacrifice.
Amen.
Amen. We talked about sacrifices in reference to killing and slaughter and giving up. But here he's not talking about killing, not talking about slaughter, nor is he talking about giving up.
Amen.
He's talking about what? Living. This is a living sacrifice. So how do I do this? He says, holy and acceptable to God.
Amen.
Well, one thing about God's children, Bible Fellowship, y'all know how to be holy.
Amen.
If we want to be holy, we got to do what? Love God, obey God, and what?
Trust
God.
Amen.
And that knocks that out right there, huh?
Yes, sir.
If we love him, obey him, and trust him, we're being what? Holy. And he says, this is what? The acceptable to God, which is your reasonable worship. See, reasonable worship, your reasonable service. This is what we're supposed to do.
Amen.
This ain't doing nothing special.
Yes, sir.
We're supposed to love him.
Yes, sir.
We're supposed to obey him.
Yes, sir.
We're supposed to trust him.
Yes, sir.
That's reasonable.
Yes.
That ain't special.
Yes, sir.
It ain't no big thing because you love him. It ain't no big thing because you obey him or trust him. That's just what?
What you're supposed to do.
That's what you're supposed to do.
Yes, sir.
That's what you're supposed to do. And then secondly, he makes a statement not to be conformed, good God from glory, to this world.
Amen.
Oh, my, oh, my. In 2018, Brother Don, that's hard.
Yes, sir.
That's hard not conforming to this world. Because everything that we do, everybody is trying to be what? Politically
correct.
Correct.
Amen.
And everything that's politically correct is not biblically correct. Amen.
Amen.
So we can run around here doing what everybody else is doing and being politically correct, but yet we're not abiding by the word of God.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
So we have to think about these things. We say, I'm going to conform to this. Oh, everybody else is doing it. Everybody else is doing it, but everybody else is falling further and further away from God.
Come on, Pastor.
Do I want to do that?
No, sir.
Do I want to fall further away from God? Or do I want to draw nearer?
Nearer
to God,
nearer
my God to thee.
Yes, sir.
It says, be ye not conformed to this world. Huh?
Yes.
Why? Some songwriter said, living for Jesus, a life that is true, striving to please him in all that I do.
Amen.
This is the pathway. No, you didn't hear me. This is the pathway for blessings for you.
Yes.
Not conforming to the world, but what? Living for Jesus.
Amen.
Mm.
Amen.
Yeah. Thirdly, I'm right on down here because we all have some football we want to watch. Amen. Amen. Tell the truth and
Amen.
What?
Shame the devil.
Amen.
Amen.
He says, and do not be conformed to this world, but be what?
Transform. Amen.
Transform. Transform. transformed. Being an electrician all of my life, a technician, I'm proud of that too. Amen.
Amen.
Thank God for it.
Amen.
Because he gave me the talent. Amen. Amen. But I thank him for it. But a transformer takes AC and turns it into
direct
DC.
Current. Yes, sir.
Huh? See, alternate current comes in the transformer and direct current comes out.
Mm-hmm.
It transforms it. So what does it do? It changes.
Come on, Pastor.
It.
Come on.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
So here this word says to be transformed. Now there's corals in there that actually do the changing. But here Paul tells us the mechanism that's going to do the transform.
Come on, Pastor.
And the mechanism,
yes, sir,
that's going to do the transforming is our mind.
Come on.
And how is it going to do it? It says by the renewing of your mind of what? The good and perfect will of God.
Amen.
Now, what do we know? Jesus said, a new commandment I give unto you. What? That ye what?
Love one another.
Huh? Now, when I looked in the Old Testament and we was there on Thursday night and we read to love the God, thy God, with all your heart, with all your might, all your mind and strength. And then it said to what? To write it on the what? The doorposts. Huh? Make a sign. Put it on the wall. Why is that? So that you can do what? Renew your mind. No, you didn't hear me.
Come on.
You gotta have something,
yes,
around your house,
yes,
that you can look at. Your refrigerator and see a sticker on it,
yes,
that,
sir,
you can look at, a poster on the wall that lets you know that Jesus is the Christ,
yes,
the Son of the living God.
Glory
and
to God.
Let you know that your job is to love. And let you know that you need to open up your Bible. And why did he want them to renew their minds? Because God has been good to you.
Amen.
Oh, you don't hear me.
Yes, sir.
See, God has been good, and as good as God has been to me, I can't worship nobody else.
Huh? Yes, sir.
As good as God has been to me, I gotta tell somebody, huh?
Yes, sir.
Because I don't know about you, but I've had a whole lot of good times,
huh?
Amen. I have had a lot of good times where God has done it for me.
Amen.
Where God has been there for me. Where God has blessed me.
Amen.
And because he had, I'm going to worship him.
Amen.
I'm going to give it all to him.
Amen.
I'm getting ready to close now.
Yes, sir.
I'm getting ready to close this book right now. Because you see, what the word is telling us this morning is that if we are to become living sacrifices,
amen,
we got to give our what? Our life,
yes,
to,
sir,
God. We got to give it to him. We can't conform to this world. We don't have,
yes,
to,
sir,
worry about being politically correct. What,
yes,
we need to worry about being is biblically correct.
Amen.
We have to be transformed. I like,
yes,
the way,
sir,
I used to be, but something wonderful,
yes,
has,
sir,
come over me.
Yes, sir.
He's changed my life.
Yes, sir.
And now I'm free.
Yes.
Has,
yes,
it,
sir,
come over to you? And because it's come over me, all,
yes,
things ain't like they used to be.
Yes.
Well, I've had some good times.
Yes.
And I've had some bad times.
Yes, sir.
But all of my good times,
yes,
outweigh my,
yeah,
bad times.
Come on,
and I won't.
Come on, Pastor.
I won't.
Yes, sir.
I won't complain.
Yes, sir.
I say I won't complain.
Yes, sir.
The good,
yes, sir,
outweighs the bad.
Yeah.
The,
yes,
good,
sir,
outweighs the bad.
Yes.
And I won't. Come on, Gillian. I won't. I won't. I won't.
Yes.
Complain.
Amen. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
of the day.
Yes.
I've had some heels to climb. I've had some weary days.
Yeah.
today.
Yes.
So
so instead of complaining, I learned how to lift them hands.
Yeah.